everyone, welcome back at Charlotte from At Charlotte's House. It is a beautiful night here. I am out on my patio, and today I am sharing how I made this fun, colorful pattern box for a cooler. Stay tuned. I'm trying to bring some color to this patio. It is a beautiful space. It looks out over a pond when the sun sets. There is no better place to sit and have a cocktail, but we needed a place to put those cocktails. So I thought it would make sense to have a permanent box where we could stick a cooler if need be, and I love what a colorful addition this is to the space.
I am super excited to be joining my friends Sam and Jen to share a scrap wood project for their Build at Home series. Needless to say, I had plenty of scrap wood to work with. I started by pulling everything out to see what I was dealing with. Turns out I had a ton of 1x3 common pine as well as some plywood from a project this summer. I don't have plans for this project because I end up changing things around about 100 times as I'm building, but it's a pretty simple concept, so hopefully you can follow along. The first step was to create the box itself. I was working with the dimensions of the cooler, and I didn't want this box to permanently hold the cooler, so I needed it to be large enough for us to get the cooler in and out. I also needed it to allow for the lid of the plastic cooler to remain open, since I wasn't planning to attach this permanently to the wooden lid of my box. I built the four legs using 1x3 common pine and pocket holes. I always like to mark which way I am drilling my pocket holes, so you can see me making this note with my pencil. Then I cut down some of my plywood for the walls. Normally I wouldn't use plywood for a project like this because I feel like it doesn't always hold up so well when it's outside just getting wet and sitting in the snow, but I knew I was gonna paint it. I also knew that I was adding another layer of that common pine, so I took the gamble because, well, it's scrap wood. Once the four legs were built, I used wood glue and wood screws to attach the sides and the ends to the legs to form the box. To create a base for the cooler so it wasn't just sitting on the ground, I drilled pocket holes in the ends of more 1x3s and I attached 8 of them spaced evenly inside the bottom edge of the box. I'm hoping that all of these slats will disperse the weight and be strong enough to hold a full cooler. Pocket holes can sometimes be a little tricky when they're through that thin, soft lumber, and they're not always the best design choice, but that's what I did, and if it falls apart, then I'll figure out another way to support the cooler. Then I sanded and painted the box itself. Once the box was built, it was time to move on to the decorative aspect of this. I've already built and painted a few pieces of other furniture for the patio, and I'm really trying to bring in a little more color to the furniture that we have out there, so I figured this might be a fun chance to really go to town. I set up a stop block on my miter saw and I cut down many, many 1x3s into squares. There was a lot of math involved and I definitely got it wrong more than once. I sanded down all the edges and then divided the squares into four groups to paint. I'll mention the paint colors down in the video description. Once the paint had dried, I used some yellow frog tape, which is intended for delicate surfaces or surfaces that you've just painted, and I taped off each square diagonally. Then I went back and painted them all again with contrasting colors. I tried to make these colors evenly distributed, but my brain fritzed out at some point, so I don't think I was keeping track. It seemed to work. When the squares were dry, I laid them out on the box and I found a pattern that I liked, i.e. just random. And then I simply used some wood glue to adhere. Again, I'm hoping that wood glue will be enough to hold these squares in place, but if for some reason they start falling off down the line, I'll go back and reattach them using a small brad nail through the middle of each one, and that should be plenty strong enough. You'll notice that the squares don't fit evenly on the long sides of the cooler box, so I painted a scrap piece of 1x4 to be sort of a decorative stripe up the middle, and I actually love it, so that's just a happy accident as a result of my bad math. I thought about ways to get cute with the lid, I considered hinges, but I ultimately decided that because the lid to the cooler is staying intact, it would be just easier for me to make my lid to the wooden box, just simple. I made a frame using 1x3s and pocket holes, and then I cut another piece of plywood to sit just inside the frame, and I attached this with wood glue and brad nails. This design means that when I flip over the lid, you can see those visible pocket holes, but I didn't want to leave the house for pocket hole plugs. I may fill those in later, but for now, it's totally fine. I sanded and painted the lid, and then I went back with painter's tape and I taped off the same geometric pattern as the sides of the box. I didn't want to use the same wooden squares as I had on the sides of the box because I was worried that water would get trapped in the cracks and then it would increase the chances for rot. Needless to say, I am crazy about how this looks and it works just like I needed it to. We can still remove the cooler and use it on the beach or at picnics, but it can live on our patio tucked safely in this wooden cooler box all other times. When we're outside entertaining or just enjoying a glass of wine while the sun goes down, the lid can come off and we can use it as a serving tray, and it is perfect.
Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to click that little bell icon so you will be notified when I share videos in the future. Cheers. Have a great day, everyone.